Hi everyone, Dr. Rowe here at Spine Care in St. Joseph, Michigan. In this quick 3D animation, I want to go over what the sacroiliac or sciatic joint is and what type of symptoms it will cause. So to begin with, let's look at some anatomy. What we're looking at is part of the lumbar spine, which is in the very low end of the back right here. So the SI joint itself is the union of the last lumbar segment, or L5, which is right here, and also the union of the sacrum, which is right here. The sacrum acts as a stabilizer for the spine itself that sits right upon that, and then also the ilium of the pelvis, which you have one right here on the right and one right here on the left, which forms then those SI joints, which would be right here. So you have two of them, left and right. So the SI joint is more or less, it consists of a narrow cartilage filled space between the two bones that are connected by strong ligaments. With the SI joints themselves, there is very little movement at all. You usually have about 4 degrees of rotational movement. However, this joint is a major weight-bearing joint and is susceptible to degenerative joint disease, which is the most common type of arthritis in this joint itself. So with degenerative joint disease, you get a lot of abnormal motion in there, and it can cause a lot of things from pain to other symptoms, including more or less low back pain. A lot of patients come in with buttock pain and also back of the thigh pain. Commonly though, I don't really see too much knee pain, but it can mimic sciatic-like symptoms going all the way down, including numbness, tingling, and loss of strength into the leg itself. So that's a quick overview of what the SI joint is. So I really do hope that this video kind of gave you a general understanding of what the sacroiliac joint is and kind of helps answer what might be causing your lower back, buttock, or leg pain. Thanks for watching, and if you really like the video, please give us a like or a thumbs up.